East LA, pretty much you either go to school, play sports, or join a gang. You know, and me, I was fortunate enough to have both my parents were, they kept me in sports my whole life. So I was out, I would never thought about becoming a gang member.
Early, my life began early childhood, like about 10, 11. Grew up on a real, real rough side, back in 90 something. Seen a lot of things that I shouldn't have been seeing pretty young, pretty rough, and it's very, very hard, especially when you didn't have enough help from your own parents towards growing up, towards being around, because they wanted a better life for me.
Está un poquito mejor la vida aquí, pero hay que trabajar diario. Hasta ahorita no hay pandillas aquí pintando ni nada de eso, como en otras pueblos de aquí mismo que sí están llenos de grafitis y todo eso. Nos acaban de hacer una escuela técnica aquí, una cuadra, y pues es para beneficio de los niños de nosotros, pues. Ya los míos ya no van a alcanzar eso, pero los nietos a lo mejor sí ya. No voy a decirte que me voy a ir a Hollywood a vivir, ¿verdad? Porque pues no, las condiciones de vida de nosotros pues es diferente. Pero está bueno aquí para vivir. No hay problema.
You know, unfortunately, the gangs still exist here in East LA, but personally, I think it's how you raise your kid. You know, if you focus them on going to school, then I don't think it should matter where you live.
A lot of us are college educated, and you know, they tend to put us down and think the community's bad, but it really ain't. It's not as bad as people think it is, you know, it's a beautiful place.
Y gracias a Dios estamos aquí y vivimos mejor que en Honduras.
I love all my family, my friends, I mean, people I've known all my life, everybody here. I mean, it's kind of difficult for me to go. I have gone elsewhere, but I'm just so used to being here, so I think I'm gonna die here.
East LA's four boundaries are, so from the south side is Union Pacific, on the north side is Floral, east side is Atlantic, and Indiana is west side. You see their people's cars, you'll say born in East LA, or actually the high school that I went to, it's Garfield, it says made in East LA, or their jerseys say that because they're just so proud of being from here and make sure that everybody knows, yeah, we're from here and nothing's gonna change. My grandparents had five kids. One of them ended up being a gang member. The other one's actually a cop. And they were brought up by the same values, the same traditions. I think it has a lot to do with the people you hang out with and the people you associate yourself, especially in the beginning between elementary and junior high. And I think that literally affects how your life's gonna be here in East LA. My grandparents go to church every Sunday. They actually go twice every Sunday. Every little kid has to be baptized. There's a saying in Spanish that says, yo te digo quién eres y a ver con qué te juntas, which pretty much says, like, I'll tell you who you are just by seeing the people you hang out with. My girlfriends were my support group. I think we all had the same goals in life. You know, they're all different types of majors, but we all had the same goals and the same aspects of life and what we wanted to achieve. And if you hang out with them, it made life easier. It was a lot easier to comprehend. So I wanted to be a vet in the beginning, but I can't stand the sight of blood. So I ended up with architecture, and even throughout high school, all 4 years, I had architecture and drafting, and that's where I developed my skills. And then when I actually thought about what I was gonna do when I grew up, I had to see myself actually enjoying it and doing it for my rest of my life, and architecture just came to me easy. I believe if you make a great building and if a lot of people like it, they'll feel for it. My grandparents are very traditional people. The men are the head of the household, the woman stays home and cooks, and it's like whatever they need, you gotta provide for them. They can't get up. So sometimes it's kind of tough, and you don't agree with those things. It was a kind of difficult at first, especially with my grandparents going into a male profession, especially my grandpa. It's like, what? Isn't that a guy's job? Yes, I'm a woman, so what? I'm a Latina, so what? I went to the same type of school you went to. I'm learning the same as you. It doesn't make me any different from you, except that I'm a woman and a Latina. One of the proudest moments of my life. It was pretty cool. My whole family was there. It was like a little emotional because everybody was just crying, and just like, it was pretty cool. Like I said, it's like 6 years of your life. You pretty much are blocked off from like your family. Like architecture is like it's family within itself. You're there 24/7, and you rarely see your family unless it's like finals are over or it's maybe summer. Other than that, you're always in school. So actually achieving that, it was like a big moment. And see my grandparents, my uncles, everybody just cheering. It was pretty cool. I'm the only one in my family that has a degree. My family's so proud. Like they always make sure when they ask, like, oh, how's Yuri or how's this? They always make sure, like, oh yeah, Yuri got her degree. Like they make that an emphasis. Like she has it in architecture, and they're very proud of that. As my community, some of them my friends know, and they know it's like, oh, well, how could he help the community? Like I said, especially right now, because it's still not an actual city. They're like, you should try to use that as a stepping stone and maybe helping out and actually get a voice in the community to make it better. I'm very proud of being raised here, and I still live here because it's the best. It does have a lot of bad stigma, when people are not around here, but it's like any other city, like it does have its bads and its goods, but it's home.
Volver, volver, volver a tus brazos otra vez. Llegaré hasta donde estés. Yo sé perder. Quiero volver, volver, volver.